哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名讲正道。
Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I speak.
啊，主所亲爱的大家，主里平安。
Brothers and sisters, whom the Lord Jesus loves, peace be with you.
啊，靠着圣灵的帮助。
By the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们继续在风雨中前进。
We continue to forge forward in a storm.
与教会一同前进。
Together with the church.
与福音神的道一同前进。
Together with the gospel and the word of God.
不是在平平安安中前进
，and not to march forward only in times of peace，
是在风暴中，在各样的阻挡中不断的前进
，but in times of the storms of all forms of hindrances，
一直把福音传到地极
，that we are able to preach the gospel to the ends of the earth，
一直完成到完成主耶稣托付的使命为止
，until we are able to complete the mission that's commissioned to us by Jesus，
前进到自己生命结束的那一天
to march forward until the end of our lives
但是生命的结束不代表福音就停止
but at the end of our lives does not mark the end of the gospel
因为我们还有栽培下一代还有栽培很多神的仆人
because we also have to cultivate our next generation as a generation of workers of God
我不在了他不在了你不在了还有其他的人不断的前进
when we are no longer there when you are no longer here there are also other people continuously marching forward
这个重点也是在今天十六章看得到的
This is also what we can stress on from chapter 16.
好，那这十六章传道给他一个主题叫做马其顿的异象。
I entitled this chapter with the theme, the vision in Macedonia.
啊，从本章十六、十七、十八这三章里面。
From this chapter to 16, 17, and 18.
是保罗第二次巡回布道、旅行布道的这个记录，这个行程记录。
It's the full record of the second missionary journey by Paul.
从这三章的记录，你可以了解第二次旅行。布道的一些过程，一些发生的事。
From the record of these three chapters, we are able to understand the historical record of this second missionary journey.
就在这第二次的布道当中，神借着保罗把福音传到地极。
And it is through these few chapters that we are able to see God using Paul preach the gospel to the ends of the earth.
这是主耶稣所托付的使命，把福音传到地极。
This is also a mission entrusted by the Lord Jesus to preach the gospel to the ends of the earth.
但是开始他策划第二次旅行布道的时候，保罗自己的意思、自己的计划是没有这个意思的，没有把福音传到欧洲的。
But in the initial planning of Paul, he did not intend to preach the gospel to Europe.
这个不是他的计划，也不是他的意思来的。
It was not part of his plan. It was not part of his intent.
这完全是神的意思，圣灵的意思。
This is completely the will of the Lord Jesus, the Holy Spirit.
所以本章里面就出现了一个很有名的马其顿的意象。
Which is why this chapter is a very famous one, a vision of Macedonia.
马其顿是属于欧洲。
Macedonia is part of Europe.
啊，福音传入马其顿，就是福音传入地极的一个新的里程碑，新的开始。
For the gospel to enter into Macedonia is also one of the new milestone of the gospel.
那第二次的旅行步道呢，同工有希拉。
And this second missionary journey is when Paul was accompanied by Silas.
还有这个在培训当中的提摩太。
And also Timothy, who was sort of a trainee.
还有这个《使徒行传》的作者路加。
And also the author of Acts of the Apostles, Luke.
还有我们很熟悉的一对夫妻，百基拉跟亚基拉这对夫妻。
And also the couple whom we're very familiar with, Priscilla and Aquila.
这几个工人都是保罗第二次旅行布道的好同工。
These few names of the workers of God are also good co-workers of Paul.
那时间点在耶路撒冷会议过后不久。就开始了。
The time point of this second missionary journey started off after the council in Jerusalem.
那大约是主后五十年的时候开始第二次的布道。
It is about in the 50 AD that the second missionary journey started.
我们来读一节到三节。
We read from verses 1 to 3.
这一段圣经一开始就介绍保罗带领栽培提摩太，带着他一同去做传道工作。
This chapter started with the introduction of Paul bringing along Timothy to train him up in the evangelical work.
请读一节到三节。
Verses 1 to 3. Then he came to Derbe and Lystra, and behold, a certain disciple was there, named Timothy, the son of a certain Jewish woman who believed, but his father was Greek, was 2. He was well spoken of by the brethren who were at Lystra and Iconium, was 3. Paul wanted to have him go onwith him, and he took him and circumcised him because of the Jews who were in that region, for they all knew that his father was Greek.
好，那第一节一开始就说保罗来到特比跟路斯德。
Here in verse 1 tells us that Paul came to Derbe and Lystra.
还记得这个地方吗？
Do you remember what happened in this place?
就是大约他在第一次旅行布道的时候，大约在四年前到五年前，第一次旅行布道他所建立的教会。
This is the place where Paul first built the church in these two places in his first missionary journey.
路斯德应该我们不会忘记。
We won't forget Lystra.
因为这个地方是保罗遭遇到花千以石头的地方。
Because it's the place where Paul encountered his garlands and stones.
里面有给他很大的试探，很大的荣耀。
Which was full of temptation and also glory.
说他是神。
And calling him a god,
神的化身，神来到人间。
Calling him a god incarnate in the world.
这是魔鬼的大试探。
This is a great temptation of the devil.
但是忠心的仆人绝对不接受这种荣耀。
But a loyal, faithful servant of God won't receive or accept this kind of glory.
就是主耶稣说的，不接受从人来的荣耀。
Just as the Lord Jesus did not accept the glory from from man and devil.
更不能够接受从撒旦来的荣耀，撒旦给的花钱。
And also never to accept a garland from the devil.
结果你不接受是吗？就石头来对付你，来伺候你。
And since you reject the garlands, the stones will come to attack you.
就是被他打到已经以为他死掉了。
He was so badly beaten up to the point that people thought he was already dead.
有许多解经家都相信他已经被打死了，是主耶稣让他活过来的。
In fact, a lot of Bible scholars who theorized that he was probably dead, but he was resurrected by the Lord Jesus.
但总之，大家都以为他死了。事实上，就大家都以为他死，包括门徒们都以为他死了，所以围着他的身体一直在看啊，没有救他。就是一直在看啊，也以为他死掉了。
But we all know
死掉了还要救什么呢？
That everyone did think that he was already dead because even the disciples surrounded him and looking at his dead body.
啊，这个事情就是在这个路斯德呀。
This happened in Lystra.
那五年后，第二次旅行又回到这个地方来探访信徒，关心信徒。来牧养信徒。
And 5 years later, Paul returned to this place to visit the members in Lystra.
这是保罗他三次复营布道的他的这个爱心呐、啊，常常回到他建立的教会去关心信徒的信仰。
This is the love of Paul that we can see throughout all his three missionary journeys, that he would always return to these places to visit the members of the churches.
那第二次来到这个地方的时候，保罗得到很大的安慰，很大的喜乐。
In his second visit to Lystra, Paul was very much comforted.
就是这里第一节说，在那边哦，路斯德教会有一个人叫做提摩太。
It is because when he arrived at Lystra, he saw a certain disciple named Timothy.
他发现这位青年呐、啊、是非常爱主、非常优秀的青年。
He noticed him, this youth being a youth who loves the Lord Jesus very much.
也是他非常疼爱栽培的青年。
He is also one that Paul was very willing to cultivate and groom.
所以他就带他哈、哦、栽培他，带他一起出去布道了。
He brought along Timothy to groom him throughout his evangelical work.
那有很大的可能就是这个提摩太什么时候信主呢？
So what was the likelihood when did Timothy believe in Jesus?
应该就是在他第一次传道到这里的时候呢，被石头打的那段时间他信主。那个时期了。
It was very probable that Timothy believed in Christ when Paul was beaten nearly to death when he was in Lystra.
说不定他自己也亲眼看到保罗被打到半死，哦。就算没有看到，也风闻这件大事情呐、啊，这件事情呐、啊。
We could even assume that Timothy might be one of the eyewitnesses when Paul was beaten nearly to death, or perhaps he also heard of this great news in the Lystra.
这件事一定让这个提摩太在他的内心里面起了很大的震撼，很大的一种反复思想。
And this event definitely became a very strong and powerful impression for Timothy to think about his faith.
最让人感动的就是保罗被打得半死过后呢，他一醒过来。重新又回到 被打的那个地方、啊、又回到那去面对那些人、啊、面对进入那个城市里去。
What is even more touching is that after Paul was beaten nearly to death in this place, he was willing to still return to this place after this.
还去关心他们，安慰他们，不要难过，不要害怕。
To show concern, to give comfort to the members there.
还安慰他们说，进入神的国必须要经历许许多多的艰难。进入神的国必须经历许多的艰难，安慰他们。
Comforting the members there, saying that to enter into the heavenly kingdom, we will go through much affliction and troubles.
其实又不是他们被逼迫，是保罗被逼迫啊，被保罗被打，但是他却安慰他们。
But it was not they who were being beaten up, but Paul was the one who was beaten up, but he was giving the comforting words.
所以很大的可能，这件事情让这个提摩，这个青年提摩太很大震撼，很大的感动。
So this could probably become a very strong motivation to Timothy as a source of comfort and also
and moved. He was moved. This
probably moved Timothy to have the heart to sacrifice for the Lord Jesus and to love the Lord God just the same way Paul did.
那么这个提摩太的名字呢，意思叫做尊敬神。
The name Timothy has the meaning of honoring God.
尊敬神，你有尊敬神吗？
Do you honor God?
另外一个意思叫做神所尊重的。
The second meaning is the one who is honored by God.
这个是他名字的两个意思。
These are two meanings of this name.
一个懂得尊敬神的年轻人，怎么不叫人喜爱他呢？
A young man who knows how to honor God, wouldn't he be very much favored by people?
你看第二节。
Verse 2.
不单指路斯的人喜欢他，以哥念的弟兄也称赞他，两处不同教会的弟兄姐妹都喜爱他，肯定他，称赞他。
Not only the brethren who was at Lystra speaks good of him, and the people in Iconium also praised him a lot.
当然就是这个青年有他的优秀，有他对神的那种敬畏神的态度，那种表现。
And this youth definitely demonstrated a very outstanding behavior of worshiping God and honoring God.
所以我们教会弟兄姐妹，哪一个弟兄是叫提摩太的，你要留意啦。你的名字叫做尊敬神，知道吗？那你有没有尊敬神啊？你自己要常常检讨哦。
So brothers and sisters, any one of you who has this name Timothy, it means you are honoring God, and have you honored God truly?
其实我们都每个人都应该是提摩太，叫做尊敬神，意思就是尊敬神，每一个都是尊敬神。
And in fact, all of us should carry this name that we all need to honor God.
那不单只是尊敬神，它第二个意思叫做神所尊重的。
And not only is we honor God, but it is we are also being honored by God.
不单只人喜爱你，你更得到神的喜爱。
Not only that God loves us, people also love us.
你这样尊重神，神一定尊重你的。
If we honor God, the Lord God will honor us.
这不是传道讲的。
This is not spoken by the preacher.
这是主耶稣亲自讲的。
This is spoken personally by the Lord Jesus.
你尊敬神，你爱神，神一定尊敬你，一定爱你。
If you love and honor God, the Lord God will love and honor you.
有没有耶稣有没有讲过这篇道理？
Did the Lord Jesus say this?
请看《约翰福音》书十二章。
Return to John chapter 12。
约翰福音书十二章二十六节。
Gospel of John chapter 12 verse 26。
耶稣回答，二十六章哈，请你念二十六章。
二十六章啊。Gospel of John chapter 20。
对不起，是十二章，对不起。
Chapter 12 verse
二十六节。
26。Verse 26, if anyone serves me, let him follow me, and where I am, there my servant will be also. If anyone serves me, him my Father will honor.
有没有？耶稣说，若有人要服侍主耶稣，要服侍他，就应当跟从他呀。
If anyone serves the Lord Jesus, let him follow Jesus.
那你说你跟从主，主耶稣说我在那里，你服侍我的人一定也要在那里呀。
And you say you want to follow Jesus, you shall be where the Lord Jesus is.
主耶稣更进一步说，若有人服侍我，爱主，服侍主。我父必尊重他，天父真神必定会尊重他。
And Jesus said that if anyone serves me, him my Father will honor.
一个爱神爱主的人，神一定爱他；一个尊敬神尊敬主耶稣的人，神也会尊敬他。
One who loves and also serves the Lord Jesus also will be loved and honored by the Lord Jesus.
所以，这是主耶稣给我们的一个勉励，给我们的安慰，给我们的提醒。
This is an exhortation, a reminder, and also comforting words from the Lord Jesus.
你要神尊敬你，你必须先要先做到你尊敬神。
If you want to be honored by God, you have to first be able to honor Him.
对人也是一样。
The same way you do this to men.
人尊重你，你也要学会去尊重人啊。
You want to be respected, you have to first learn to respect others.
这个提摩太的名字就有这两个意思，这个道理存在。
This is the twofold meanings behind the name Timothy.
那么我们发现到提摩太的爸爸是外邦人，希利尼人。
Now we realize that the father of Timothy is a Greek, a Gentile.
那他的妈妈是犹太人。
And the mother is a Jewish woman.
严格讲起来，犹太人哦，犹太社会是不能够承认这样的婚姻的。
In strict customs, Jews do not acknowledge this kind of a marriage.
甚至那些很极端的、很为律法热心的，会为这样的婚姻哦、这样的婚礼哦，举行丧礼啊，举行丧礼仪式，意思说这个人死掉了，这个犹太人死掉了。 如果你嫁娶外邦是吗？他跟你举行丧礼仪式了，说死了，宣布说这个人死了。
And some of the Jewish extremists will actually conduct a funeral to declare that this person is supposedly dead by him or her marrying a Gentile.
如果父亲是犹太人，母亲是外邦人，那么生下来的孩子那就算是外邦人。
If the mother is Jewish,
不是，父亲是犹太人。
If the father is a Jew,
母亲是外邦人。
And the mother is a Gentile.
那生下来的孩子算是外邦人。
But a child that is given birth will be a Gentile.
他们不，犹太社会不承认你。
The Jewish community will not recognize him.
如果母亲是犹太人。
But if the mother is a Jew,
父亲是外邦人。
And the father is a Gentile.
那你生下来的孩子算是犹太人。
But the child that you bear shall be recognized as a Jew.
所以根据犹太人的观念，这种观念哦，提摩太算是犹太人呢、
哦。According to
因为母亲是犹太人呢、啊。
According to this kind of a Jewish concept and custom, Timothy is recognized as a Jew.
啊，传道这样讲是让大家了解一下他们的背景，他们的文化。
I'm trying to explain and elaborate to you the custom and the tradition of the Jews.
哦，保罗因为提摩太是犹太人，免得起了冲突。避免福音受到阻挡，所以你看到吗？保罗就给他行了割礼，有没有？第三节。
In order to avoid hindrances or obstacles in the evangelical work, we can see in verse 3 that Paul wanted to have him circumcised.
因为他算是
to the need for circumcision, but rather to evade the unnecessary obstacles.
但是也因为这件事情哦，日后成为被攻击的把柄啊，保罗被人家攻击啊。
But eventually, because of this, Paul also had this against himself.
啊，不久前保罗刚刚打了一场真理的胜仗，就是耶路撒冷的会议。
And not long ago, Paul just had a successful debate or dispute in the Council of Jerusalem.
就是大会议决，外邦人信主不必受割礼，已经议决了，不必受割礼。
That the council had finally come to agreement that it was not necessary for the Gentiles to be circumcised.
那为什么现在要给提摩太行割礼呢？
But why is it that Timothy had to go through circumcision?
啊，大家注意，因为提摩太算是犹太人。
Take note that it is because Timothy was recognized as a Jew.
最重要是犹太社会承认了他是犹太人。
It is important for the Jewish community to recognize him as a Jew.
这样就很麻烦了。
So it would become very tricky.
他是犹太人，你不给他行割礼是没完没了的，一定会很多阻挡，很多攻击来。
Him as a Jew, having not been circumcised, would have to face a lot of obstacles.
因为大会的议决是讨论外邦人信耶稣不必受割礼，他结论是外邦人不必受，可是没有讲犹太人不必受割礼，完全没有讨论这件事。
Because the council meeting that just happened in Jerusalem had only been talking about the need for circumcision for the Gentiles, but not about for the Jews.
所以保罗也觉得，哎呀，这个是没完没了，一直争吵，甚至影响到福音工作。那你要去割就去割了，不用讲这么多了，反正跟得救没有关系啊，你要割你就去割啊。
And Paul was probably thinking that it is not necessary for them to go through another argument against the Jews, and he would just might as well have him circumcised.
割不割都跟得救没有关系。
Because whether or not he was circumcised, it has nothing to do with his salvation.
但若因为这个割礼的问题啊，犹太人割礼的问题，造成冲突，造成分裂，造成不能够和平，造成福音受阻挡，那就去割吧。
If this,
他的原则是这样，保罗的原则是这样。
The principle of Paul was basically because he was trying to avoid any unnecessary conflict, division, and also arguments with the Jews just because he was not circumcised.
这有什么问题呢？
So what is the problem of having him circumcised?
在保罗讲是没问题的。
On Paul's end, it should be no problem.
只要不要为难外邦人，外邦人不用受割礼就 OK 了。那犹太人你自己要不要割是你的事啊。
As long as it does not burden the Gentiles that they have to be circumcised, they will do whatever the Jews need.
我们刚刚用了很多时间上一次讲了这个割礼的冲突、割礼的争辩嘛。
In the previous session, we have spent a lengthy explanation on this issue of circumcision.
看，只是在十五章而已啊。
It was only in chapter 15.
16章他就跟提摩太割礼了，所以我解释一下了。
And chapter 16, now Paul was circumcising Timothy.
并不是说保罗也赞成割礼，不是。
But it doesn't mean that Paul was in agreement to circumcision.
他是很反对割礼的。
He was strongly against circumcision.
这样明白吗？
Now do you understand?
赞成是为了避免再冲突、再分裂、再吵闹，割吧。
But he conducted this circumcision anyway for Timothy to avoid any unnecessary conflict.
那四节到五节。
Verse 4 to verse 5.
那么保罗就带着提摩太经过各城，把耶路撒冷使徒和长老所规定的规条教义交给门徒去遵守，那个就是会议的结论啊。
And they went through different cities and delivered to them the decrees to keep, which is actually the decrees confirmed from the council in Jerusalem.
到各城各教会寻睦关心啊，这个是寻睦教会，关心教会。
They went through different cities to strengthen their faith, that is to comfort them, to also pastor them.
耶路撒冷所定的规条就是我们今天讲的教义，共信之道，大家同意的，大家相信的，大家服从的，叫做共信之道，一同共。
These decrees that are determined in the Council of Jerusalem, which are also our common belief and also our basic beliefs of the church.
不能说是这是我的意见，那是你的意见，绝对不能叫做共信，大家一起相信。我们今天真耶稣教的十大信仰，全世界一同相信的。不能够说马来西亚相信，台湾不相信的。那台湾相信的，日本是不相信的，那不叫做共信哦。
This basic
没有一起相信哦，叫做没有一起相信。
These common beliefs are also likened to our 10 basic beliefs, which are held as a common belief, a common ground by all true church across the world, and we have to share a complete similar faith.
你无论到任何地方，到印度也好，到非洲也好，到任何一个角落，只要真耶稣教会，他的教义一定是共性，一定一样的，没有不一样的。
Wherever you go across the globe, in Africa, in other countries, wherever you go, our faith and our foundation of the basic beliefs are the same.
如果你说，那个非洲的真耶稣不是这样的，他的信仰不是这样，那不是真耶稣教会来的，我跟你讲。
If you find that the basic beliefs in this church in Africa is not like ours, we don't call them the true Jewish church either.
那我这里只放真耶稣教会，那是已经变质的，已经改变了的。
It is still
那绝对不是真的真耶稣教会。
Carry the signboard of true Jewish church, and they would already have the deteriorated. They are not the true Jewish church.
所以共信之道很重要，知道吗
？Therefore, the common set of basic beliefs are important.
不能说自己感觉，我自己觉得，我自己讲我的道理，好像那个魔鬼论自己来的。你自己来的，你就不是真耶稣教会的。
You cannot introduce a new set of beliefs based on your own opinions, like the theory of demonology. You cannot introduce that.
因为大家都不接受，大家也不相信，但而且也是跟真理冲突抵挡真理的道理来的。
Not only are these things which are not agreed upon, it is also opposite or against the truth of the gospel.
所以我在这个第四节说。长老使徒们所定的规条，原来就是我们的教义。
And I'm trying to explain to you that these are the decrees to keep, which are also the common beliefs that have been set by the church.
交给门徒就是交给信徒们去遵守，交给教会去遵守。
These are to be delivered to the churches, to the members, for them to keep.
所以大家都要遵守的，知道吗
？Therefore, it is all for us all to keep.
那因为这样，第五节说，于是因为这样哦。众教会信心越发坚固，大家都得到造就，大家的信心都越来越坚固。
And、because of this, verse 5, so the churches were strengthened in the faith.
众教会是就是指所有的教会。
It refers to all the churches.
有两个特点。
It carries two characteristics.
第一，信心越发坚固，不是越来越软弱，是越来越坚强。
Their faith became more strengthened, but not weakened.
第二，人数天天增加。
Secondly, their number increased daily.
就是每天都有人信主归入主耶稣里面。
That's to say that every day people are new believers are coming in.
如果今天真耶稣教会大家都同心的遵守共同的这样维护共信之道，我们的信心就会越来越坚固。我跟你讲。
If the true church stays steadfast to the common beliefs, our faith will be strengthened stronger and stronger.
今天真耶稣教会对共信之道、十大信仰有很多的意见，有一些人有很多意见。
But there are certain group of people in the true Jewish church that are having a lot of opinions regarding the basic beliefs.
有一些讲他自己的意思，讲他自己的道理。
The beliefs of the true Jewish church, and they try to explain in their own theories.
结果带来教会信心不能够越发坚固，反而让许多信徒信心动摇
And this resulted in the shaken faith and the faith of the believers being swayed and being shaken.
这是我们不允许发生的事情。
This is something that we do not want to allow to happen.
可是有一些人说我们研究啊，我们来发表啊，我们给人家自由啊，来讨论啊，动机是好的，可是却陷入了魔鬼的陷阱，跌入那个陷阱里，越讨论越模糊，越讨论越不能够共同相信，越讨论就越冲突，结果你讲你的，我讲我的。请问这种情况之下，信心会越发坚固吗？
But perhaps they have a good motive to also try to have freedom of speech and to discuss things, and eventually they are getting more and more confusing among themselves, and eventually confuse the faith of the other believers, and we fell into the trap of the devil.
我们真理研究会本来就是要越对自己的真理越坚固的，越维护越巩固的，越研究越松懈的，越研究就越动摇的，这样还要研究来做什么？所以我对一些真理研究会我很反感，我很不赞成。
The goals of the
我带着传道的使命这样讲话，这样来分析，我很不赞成。
Of the Truth Research Committee was set up in order to be able to strengthen the faith of the members even more, but now that the research has become more and more blurry and confusing to the faith of members, I as a preacher completely disagree with this.
理由是什么呢？
What, for on what ground?
理由就是这个不是越发坚固啊，反而越破坏我们的信心，越让教会动纷争啊。
This has not strengthened.
那这样研究来做什么呢？研究来的目的是什么呢？
The faith of the believers, but rather has caused even more divisions and dissensions. And what's the point of researching all this?
想要研究，你还要研究什么？圣灵启示我们的真理，一次交付，一次就说没有第二次，完全的交付，一次性的启示你，已经够了啊。
What else?
还有另外的启示，另外的解释。那不是混乱咯。
What other explanation do you still need other than the gospel that has already been entrusted to the Lord, to the true church by the Holy Spirit once and for all? What else do you want explanation for?
我们还以为对真理很有研究，很有什么样，结果上掉进陷阱了。
You think that you want to research even more, in the truth, but you have fallen into the trap.
而且那些发表的人也不谦卑啊，一直坚持他自己的，不愿意改变的，不愿意收回他的话的，他讲了他就一直坚持，一直坚持，你怎样解释他也坚持他的，你也坚持你的，这样就变成两个人在表演而已啊，两个人在讲他们的东西啊，那请问是真理吗？
And the speakers of these new proposals or the new suggestions to the truth do not have a humble heart, and they want to be very staunch with their own opinions. And do you still call that the truth?
难道你认为那个真理启示还不够吗？不够清楚吗？要你继续的研究才清楚，才更清楚吗？是这样子吗？
Do you think that the gospel or the truth that has been entrusted to us is not clear enough, and it requires even more research?
那是你去研究的，还是圣灵启示你让我们清楚？还是你研究出来的？研究出来的跟圣灵启示不一样的哦。
What has been researched out of your own opinions is different from what is entrusted by the Holy Spirit.
我为什么讲到这一点？
Why am I talking about this?
因为今天这间书教就是面对这样的危机，这样的陷阱啊。
This is a crisis and a snare that the church, the true Jesus church has faced.
我们还以为我们为真理热心啊，其实不是呀。
It is as though we appear to be very zealous for the truth, but it is not.
你看第四节、第五节的教训是什么？真理是什么？
Verse 4 to verse 5, what can you learn from this?
圣灵与我们所定义、所决定的就是这样。
Whatever that has been determined by the Holy Spirit is as this.
交给教会去遵守，大家相信，大家服从，大家跟随就对了。
And it's determined and now entrusted to the church for everyone to keep.
这样的结果是教会的信心越发坚固。
And the result of this would be their faith being strengthened.
这样的结果是主耶稣喜悦，天天加增得救的人数。
The result of this would be the increase in the favor of Jesus and also the number of the members.
所以我花很多时间在讲耶路撒冷会议的内部情形，为什么？
Which is why I took up a lot of time to explain about what is the internal context of the council in Jerusalem.
事实上，支持各里的人是很多的，多过不支持的人。
The truth of the matter was the people who supported circumcision. Was a lot more of those who don't agree.
如果用投票一定输的。
If they were to cast a vote, they would lose.
投票一定是要结论就是要赞成割礼的，我跟你讲。
Because the votes would point to supporting circumcision.
为什么会这样大的改变？
Why was there such a great change?
出乎意料的改变。
Oh, is that such an unexpected change.
因为圣灵在运行。
It was because the Holy Spirit was working with them.
后来他们写信的时候就说这是圣灵，他们自己深深的感受到真的是圣灵在带领。
And in the,
自己也感受到是圣灵在带领，所以说圣灵跟我们决定的。
And therefore, it is why that when they wrote the letters or the epistles later, they acknowledged that it was the guidance of the Holy Spirit.
那个十大信仰和五大教义不用再研究了啦。
There's no need for you to research even more regarding our ten basic beliefs and five doctrines.
难道神的启示还不够吗？那些圣经的印证还不解讲解还不够吗？
Has the revelation of the Lord Jesus Himself and also the proofs from the Bible not sufficient for you?
啊，已经一百多年了哦。
It has been a century and more.
除非你的研究是越巩固那个真理了，越巩固十大信仰了。但是事实上有看到不是这样，不是这样。
Unless your research has further strengthened the foundation of the truth, but the truth is it is not so.
但是我今天在这里讲的话，不容有谁听得到，有谁会去听啊？谁会去理你啊？
I'm not sure who among you would truly accept this message.
无论得时不得时，我们总要讲，总要分析清楚。
Whether in season or out of season, you have to discern properly.
今天的教会越来越不单纯，越来越不纯洁。
The church today has become more less and less pure.
越来越复杂。
And more complicated.
主耶稣已经把很复杂的天国道理简单化了，清楚明了了。我们却把主耶稣的话去复杂化，讲得很复杂，解释得很复杂。
The Lord Jesus.
是我们自己把它复杂化呀。
The Lord Jesus has already translated the profound message of the heavenly kingdom in simplified form, simplified it for you, but you are complicating it even more.
就像昨天晚上传道讲到的时候提出的，耶稣说把网撒在右边，今天讨论人说不一定要右边的，左边也可以，对不对？
Just like
耶稣就说右边，他说不一定，那他就提出很多理论，提出很多的理由啊。
The sermon that I shared yesterday that the Lord Jesus asked to cast the net to the right side, but there are a lot of other people who want to argue that there are other factors to consider, and you can cast out to the other side as well.
这个就是我们人的复杂，人自己去复杂神的话咯。
And this is how people are always trying to complicate the message of God.
你何必去多解释呢？说是右边就是右边咯。
Why do you have to explain more?
还不够清楚吗？就是右边呢，左右你分不清楚呀。
Wasn't the instruction of the Lord Jesus clear enough that you have to cast the net to the right side?
当然，它的右边有它的意义，有它的意思，那个是另外一件事。
And surely, perhaps there are a lot of other reasons for the Lord Jesus to ask you to cast to the right side.
但肯定就是要你杀在右边的。
But what is important is that you have to cast the net to the right side.
绝对不是叫你杀在左边的，绝对。
But not to the left side.
右边的意思就是要尊荣神啊，荣耀神啊。
You cast to the right side because you want to honor God.
因为右边哦，在圣经，在犹太人的观念，包括圣经的观念里面，右边是尊贵的地方，是非常尊贵的地方，那是要给神的，留给最尊贵的人站的，那就是神。
Because、
那就是主耶稣站的地方来的。
The right hand side is also as esteemed by the Jewish community being a place of nobility, a place of high standing.
那这一段圣经四节五节哈，我讲多了一点呐。
I've over explained verses 4 to 5.
重点是这种共性之道，众教会得到造就，信心越来越坚固，神也喜悦。
Important point is that this common set of beliefs has been edifying to the church, strengthened their faith, and the Lord Jesus was pleased.
好，六节到十节。
Verse 6 to verse 10.
这一段圣经我们看到圣灵在主导着整个福音工作、布道工作。
We can see that the Holy Spirit has controlled or guided them in this entire evangelical work.
第六节说圣灵禁止他们在亚细亚讲道。
And verse 6 tells us that the Holy Spirit forbade them from speaking at Asia.
亚细亚是罗马帝国的其中一个省啊。
Oh, and
亚细亚，罗马帝国。
Asia in verse 6 is actually one of the provinces in the Roman Empire.
就是我们启示录讲的七教会哦，其中以弗所教会什么七个教会哦，所有七个教会都是在这个省啊，就在亚细亚这个省里面啊。
And in fact, the seven churches recorded in the book of Revelation are all part of this region of Asia.
包括哥罗西教会也在这一省里面。
Even the church of Colossae is here.
那么，既然圣灵不让他们在这里哈传道，他们就想了，他们就自己想了，那我们就到腓推尼去吧。腓推尼。
And then they went to
verse 7
in Bithynia.
当他们自己要到腓帖尼去的时候，耶稣的灵又不允许，主耶稣不允许。
And they tried to go to Bithynia later, but the Holy Spirit did not permit them.
那么不允许，第八节说，他们就只好下到特罗亚去。
And since they were not being permitted by the Holy Spirit, they went to Tauros.
他们也不知道圣灵真正的意思是什么，他们也不明白。
They did not know the meaning of the Holy Spirit.
反正这里圣灵不允许，他们就走到第二个地方。第二个地方圣灵不允许，他们就走到第三个地方。
Since the Holy Spirit did not allow them to go to this place, they would proceed to another place, and not allowed also, they would proceed to another place.
那一直到特罗亚的时候，就在夜间呢。神就启示他们，给他们看异象，马其顿的异象。
And they were finally at Troas. In the night, a vision of Macedonia came to Paul.
保罗寻目这个特比跟路斯德以哥念这些众教会，以前的众教会。
And since when in the missionary journey of Paul at the Derbe, Lystra, and Iconium,
在他的计划里，他想要顺着这个罗马大道去以弗所啦。他的意思是像经过这个以前的船的这个地方，然后经过罗马大道，罗马有一条大道嘛，罗马大道去以弗所，他的意思是这样，他们的计划是这样。
And his original plan, in his personal plan, was to follow the Roman roadway to Colossus.
但是圣灵制止说不要
这样，
圣灵的意思不是要这样走。
And the will of the Holy Spirit was not for him to do this.
所以他们改变方向，经过什么火里加拉、加拉泰拉，然后北上到腓推尼啊。
And that's why they finally changed the course of their direction. They went to Bithynia and also Mysia and finally Troas.
可是这个计划又被圣灵制止。
But even then, before that, they were also being forbidden by the Holy Spirit.
第一次我们看到保罗传福音的计划被圣灵制止了。
And this is the first time that we saw that the gospel work of Paul was being forbidden by the Holy Spirit.
而且两次的计划都被圣灵停止了。
And two of these plans of his journey were being forbidden.
这时候他只能够安静地等候圣灵的带领，神的旨意。
And at this time, he could only quietly wait for the guidance of God.
当我们学习懂得安静下来的时候，愿意等神的旨意的时候，圣灵就动工了，圣灵就启示了。
Now, when we learn to quieten ourselves and calm down ourselves in our work, the Holy Spirit will come to guide us and reveal to us.
第九节说，就在夜间的时候，在那个晚上夜间的时候，显出马其顿的异象来。
Verse 9 tells us that in the night, a vision of Macedonia came to Paul.
夜间是有它的意思啊。
There's a meaning behind this nighttime.
夜间就是指在黑暗的时期，黑暗的时刻。
This refers to the time of darkness.
那很多人在黑暗的时刻不知道何去何从，在这段时间不懂要怎么办好，因为黑暗啊，看不到光，看不到路啊，看不到希望，不知道怎么办好。
In the darkness of night is also when most people are feeling lost and confused, and they have no idea where to go.
那保罗的心情也是这样啊，不知道圣灵的意思是怎么样啊，要走去哪里啊，要到哪里去传啊，不知道呀。
This is similar to the feelings of Paul and not knowing the will of the Holy Spirit and where exactly to go.
马其顿异象就这样出现了。
And now the vision of Macedonia came to him.
原来神的心意不是要一直停留在亚洲。
Turned out that the will of the Lord God was not for him to stay in Asia.
神要把福音冲出亚洲，进入到欧洲里面去。
But rather for the gospel to break through the barriers of Asia, but into Europe.
这就是神的心意。
This was the will of God.
并不是说亚洲不需要传。
It was not that Asia did not require the gospel.
亚洲还有很多地方还没有传的。
There also are the regions in Asia that was not being preached. 但圣灵
的心更迫切。
But the will of the Holy Spirit was stronger.
因为还有更远更多的地方连福音都没有听过的。
Because there are also places beyond this region that have not heard of the gospel.
一直在亚洲打转，一直在亚洲这个地区传福音，什么时候进入到欧洲啊？什么时候福音到那边去啊？
If they are just tumbling and circling around in Asia, and when will the gospel reach the shores of the Europe?
所以我们传福音做圣工，真的是要明白神的旨意，要顺着圣灵的旨意来进行来行啊。
For us to evangelize and preach the gospel, we have to understand the will of God and accompany and complement the will of God.
可是我们人的意识很强。
But the will of man is very strong.
因为我们已经计划好了，我们整年的节目都好了，我们就是这样规定的。请注意，每次都说我们就是这样的，我们一年计划这样，难道不能够改变吗？一定要这样才是计划。改变的顺从圣灵的意思，那不是计划吗？
We have already planned and pre-planned an annual agenda of schedule, and we have to stick with it. But can you not change according to the will of God?
神的工作，圣灵工作是活的，有生命的。他可以随时因为各种情况，神的意思改变的呀。
The work of,
顺着神的意思，圣灵的意思去走啊，可以的呀。
The work of God is alive and it can change according to the will of God.
不要死板板，我们是定了，我们今年就是这样。
Do not be completely stuck up in your fixed plans.
那么并不是说这些地方哦，这些亚细亚这些地方哦，并不是说这个地方不需要福音，绝对不是。
It definitely did not mean that parts of this Asia no longer require the gospel.
而是就在这个时刻，这个时间点，圣灵有更迫切，有另外的安排，有另外的工作给我们。
It is rather because at this time point, the Holy Spirit has a stronger will for the gospel to be preached elsewhere.
简单说，圣灵他有工作的时间点，也有他工作的地点地方。
Simply put, there is a time and also a place by the will of the Holy Spirit for his evangelical work.
你看，保罗进入到第三次旅行布道的时候。
Now that Paul was entering into the third missionary journey,
就重新回到这些地方，亚细亚这些地方啊，那圣灵禁止的地方。
He had to now visit these places in Asia which were being forbidden here in this world.
而且还在那边停了很久啊，最久啊，在以弗所三年啊。
And
单单以弗所就三年这么久啊，因为他就倒回去啊，圣灵就同意啊。
And these are the places where he returned to and spent even longer than before. And this is now in the place of Ephesus, and the Holy Spirit allowed.
神的工作是很灵活的，是有生命力的，不是死死板板的哈。
And the work of the work of God is alive, is flexible, and is not stuck up.
最重要就是要顺着圣灵的意思，圣灵的感动来进行呐。
What is important that we complement the will and the motivation of the Holy Spirit.
那你怎么知道是圣灵的感动，圣灵的意思呢
？Then you ask, how do I know that it is the will of the Holy Spirit?
平时都不祷告，平时也不尊重神，平时也不常常顺从圣灵的，你怎么会知道？
If you are one who have not been praying on usual times and you have not been honoring God in your everyday life, and that you wouldn't know.
我们如果是一个尊敬神的人，是个爱神的人，是一个尊神伟大的人，常常感动，常常祷告，顺从圣的人，你一定知道，在祷告中你就知道，神就感动你，神就让你知道。
If you are someone who is prayerful, who loves God, and who also sets God in the first place, and the Lord God will motivate you, will touch you in your prayer.
今天我们当然不知道啊，今天很多人当然不知道啊。
And today, most of you will not know.
因为我们圣灵感动我们了，我们常常消灭圣灵的感动，我们常常不理圣灵的指示，不理他，不看重他。
The Holy Spirit may have moved you, but you are, killing the motivation.
比如说圣灵感动你要来聚会，要来热心，要来爱主。
Perhaps the Holy Spirit has moved you to come to church to love God and to be zealous for God.
今天是安息日，你要敬拜主。
On a Sabbath day, and you have to worship.
在你心里一直打转，一直说要叫，一直要来聚会。
And this thought is remains in your heart to ask you to come to church.
突然间想到说，我很久不到教会，我觉得我对不起神。这个其实就是圣灵在感动你啊。
And this sudden inspiration,
这个就是圣灵在你心里面感动呀。
This sudden inspiration in your heart came to you that you want to come back to church to worship God for the longest time. You did not.
可是你都消灭他的感动啊！我很忙啊，我哪里有时间？我不可能的啦！哎，我去做我的事了啊！我去跟朋友有了约会了，我们已经讲好要去哪里见面。一次这样，两次这样，三次这样。
And now you
常常都消灭圣灵的感动。
You ignore the message of the Holy Spirit, and you say that you are busy and you have already plans set in place for the day, and you do not come.
所以不是圣灵没有感动你，圣灵已经感动你，你也知道了，可是你消灭它呀。
And it's not that the Holy Spirit did not move you. The Holy Spirit has already indeed moved you, but you ignore it.
请问这么多年都是这样，请问你怎么会知道神的意思呢？
And you do this for.
就算神的意思启示你的，你怎么会去知道这是神的？你不也不知道的梦叉叉的。
You keep doing this for the many years back, and you wouldn't be able to tell that it was the motivation of the Holy Spirit anymore.
我为什么讲到这一点呢
？Why am I talking about this？
就是有人问什么叫做神的旨意？我怎么知道是神在感动我
？Because people ask that how do I know that this is the message or the will of the Holy Spirit？
传道就解释。
Then I'm explaining to you.
如果常常顺服圣灵的。而且真信圣灵感动的，你一定知道神的意思。
For one who
一定知道圣灵的意思。
Who has always been submissive to the will of the Holy Spirit, who has been prayerful, you will know.
你不可能说不知道的。
It is impossible for you not to know.
今天很多人不知道圣灵的感动，不知道圣灵的意思，因为我们常常不理会圣灵。
Nowadays,
所以当然不知道咯。
People do not cannot tell what's the will of the Holy Spirit and will of God, and because we are always ignoring the motivation of the Holy Spirit all along.
那么他们一看到这个圣灵的异象哦，启示哦，他们就哦决定要到马其顿去了。
From this revelation, in this vision of Macedonia, they decided to go to Macedonia.
第十节，我们就要到马其顿传福音给那边的人听了。
They sought to go to Macedonia to preach the gospel there.
你看，他们很快就收到圣灵的意思，很快就明白圣灵的意思，很快就顺服圣灵的意思，看到没有？
They saw the vision and they immediately understood the message of this vision and they did accordingly.
顺便，这里有一个很重要的真理。
And there's an important truth here.
就是独一真神跟外教会说的三位一体的问题。
The issue or the dispute of the one true God and also Trinity.
你从这里有看到三个称呼，三种称呼，一个是叫圣灵，一个叫做耶稣的灵，一个叫做神，有没有？
Now you can see these three entities mentioned in this passage: the Spirit, the God, the Spirit of God, the Spirit of Jesus.
六节是叫圣灵。
Verse 6 is called the Holy Spirit.
那个是七节下半段说是耶，就又变成就叫做耶稣的灵。
And verse 7 is referring to the Spirit of Jesus.
到十节下半段的时候，就以神召我们，就叫神了。
Verse
10 神的意思了。
Tells us that it is the Lord God Himself. It was His will.
外教会来讲，这个叫做三位一体，三位是一体的。
For secular,
是不是叫做三合一？我不知道 ，three in one.
For secular churches, and this passage was used by them to attest to Trinity as a three in one concept.
可是这个三位一体是整本圣经没有的，没有叫做三位一体，没有这个字的，没有这个字眼，没有这个字的。
But this terminology of Trinity is not even found in the Bible.
是那些解经家、外教会的神学家。自己发明这个叫三位一体这个字哦，来解释三位一体。圣经没有三位一体的。
And this is the word invented by the secular biblical scholars and theologians to describe this relationship.
请注意，三位一体是那些神学家、解经家自己发明来的词句。
The word Trinity.
三位一体，神是三位一体。
The word Trinity was invented by these secular people to explain.
他们自己也解释不清楚。
The entities of God and they themselves could not understand.
你到底是三位还是一个？
They themselves.
你说他一个，他又三个；你说三个，他又一个体，一个。到底三个还是一个？他自己也讲不清楚。我跟你讲。
They can't even explain fully or very well to you whether God was a three entity or just one God.
让人家很矛盾，很模糊。
And the people get even more confused.
原来这根本不是圣经的讲法，也不是圣经的启啊，有这样的记录都没有。
And turns out,
自己讲出来的道理，给出来的名称。
This was never the message from the Bible, and it was only being given and added upon by the people.
圣经有给一个名称，三位有给一个名称叫做独一真神。
But what the Bible has named God with is the one true God.
这就是我们真耶稣教会的独一的真理。独一真神，我们不叫三位一体，我们叫独一真神。这个是有圣经的，圣经叫做独一真神。
This is based on the truth of the gospel that the true Jewish church acknowledges that God is the one true God.
因为圣灵也就是耶稣的灵，也就是耶稣。
Because the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of Jesus.
耶稣就是真神。
And the Lord Jesus is the true God.
六节讲圣灵，六节啊七节下面讲耶稣，第十节讲神，圣灵、耶稣、神。原来圣灵就是耶稣，耶稣就是神。神就是耶稣，耶稣就是圣灵。
Verse 6,
就是独一真神啊，就是一个而已啊。
Tells us of the Holy Spirit, 7 tells us of the Spirit of Jesus, verse 10 tells us of God. These are all the same one entity, the one true God.
所以不要模糊掉，被骗了。什么叫三位？他，我跟你讲，他怎样解释来解释，他自己也矛盾的。你问他到底是三个还是一个，他又说没有，是一个。那一个为什么有三个？他说有三个啊，圣灵啊，父啊，子啊。但是你问下去又是一个，等下又是三个，到底多少个？他自己都乱了，跟你讲，解不清楚的。
And Trinitarian Christians can't even explain to you very well as to whether they are really three or actually just one, or whether one are in three or three are in one. They can't even explain.
我们不要理他讲什么了，那是人讲的名称来的，真的是圣经没有的，确实是。
But we can,
没有这样的三位一体的。
We can completely ignore what they are arguing because it is not based on the Bible.
就回到圣经很单纯的独一真神。就是一个，圣灵也是他，耶稣也是他，真神也是他，就是一个。
With simplicity of heart, we return to the Bible and we see that there is only one true God and only one.
圣灵也叫做耶稣的灵，耶稣也叫做第十节的神啊。
Which is why the Holy Spirit is also known as the Spirit of Jesus, also known as God.
如果要解释，传道打一个比方啊。
I can quote an example for you.
比如说我啦，我就是一个，全世界只有一个我嘛，哈。
There's only me alone in this world.
我在家里的时候，我的孩子叫我爸爸。我的身份是爸爸。
My children.
他们称呼我，我的名称叫做爸爸。
Call me at home, father.
可是我到社会的时候，我在工作场所，在社会的时候，他们叫我陈先生。老陈啊，还是陈什么啊，都称呼我陈先生啊 ，Mr. Jin 啊。
In the society, people call me Mr. Chin.
那可是我在教会的时候，你们称呼我什么？陈传道。
In the church,
我就变成我的名称叫做传道去了。
You call me Preacher Chin.
其实你怎样称呼我都好，家里的爸爸也好，外面的陈先生也好，还是教会的传道好，就是我一个，我就是一个而已啊。
Whether you call me,
就是一个而已，我哪有两个，我哪有三个啊？
Whether people call me Father, Mr. Chin, Preacher Chin, I'm still one person.
原来是因为工作的不同，那个救赎经纶、救赎计划的需要跟不同，有不同的身份，有不同的称呼。
It is because
在社会的，还是在教会的，还是在家里的，都有不同称呼。
It is due to
其实就是独一。
The different context of the salvation plan that was required to be done, that came the different way to address.
这样明白吗？
Do you understand now?
太简单了，传道，你讲的太简单了，我不信。
Preacher, you are making it too simplistic. I don't believe it.
你不信就变成三位一体喽，那讲没完没了的，自己也矛盾的喽。
And now you don't want to believe what I say, then you are trying to confuse yourself with Trinity.
冇咁复杂，回到简单，讲简单啲。
It is not so complex after all, and you have to be simply simple.
照着圣经给我们的启示，就是独一真神，这是有圣经根据的。
According to the revelation by the Bible, that this is the one true God that we have.
这是顺便跟大家分析一下了。
This is something for me to elaborate for you.
耶稣又叫做圣灵，又叫做耶稣，耶稣灵又叫做神。
The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of Jesus, also God Himself.
我们暂时先讲到这里。
Let us conclude here.
那么我们星期二进入到十一节里面，继续马其顿的意象。
On the coming Tuesday, we will enter into verse 11 onwards into the vision of Macedonia.
来唱诗274首 B.
We sing him 274B.
那么旧的诗歌本哦，旧的诗歌本是487啊。
487 in the old hymn book.
这首诗比较少唱了，是吗？
We rarely sang this hymn, haven't we?